Coffee. To drink coffee is to love it.
Americanos Latinx como yo nos encanta el café. De hecho, bebemos la mayor cantidad de café de cualquier otro grupo étnico en los Estados Unidos.
While a really good cup of coffee can be hard to find in the average American joint, enter almost any Cuban restaurant, from Manhattan to Miami to Minnesota, and you're likely to find the espresso machine of a barista's dreams. So, how did this tiny seed become one of Latin America's biggest economic exports and a social staple of Latinx culture in the U.S.?
First, we need to get the coffee bean from here to here and quickly. In 850 AD, a goat herder named Caldi noticed his flock dancing erratically after nibbling on a conspicuous bush of berries. Caldi thought, that looks fun. He ate some himself, but hated the taste, so he spat the remnants into a fire, and thus coffee was roasted for the very first time.
Well, I love the story, but I mean, it's just not true. It's an origin story that first appeared around in the 1670s when people were trying to explain coffee to Europeans. What I love about the story is it captures so much of the way that coffee evolved in the first few centuries that we know.
Come on. Never let the truth get in the way of a good story. Back to the fun. In 1720, French naval officer Gabriel Matou de Clure requested a coffee plant from France's royal garden. But the king was like, no friend. De Clure raided the garden that night, then quickly hopped on a boat across the Atlantic with his stolen plant. Their ship, the Dromedaire, was nearly sunk by high sea storms and attacked by pirates. Yes, pirates! De Clure protected his struggling plant and even shared his scarce water rations in their final hours. Heroically, they survived, and thanks to De Clure, Latin America got its first coffee tree.
This is a beautiful story. Unlike Caldi, De Clure really existed, and he wrote the story. We kind of think he might have made himself perhaps just a little bit more of a hero. But what we can really say for absolute sure is this is the time coffee spreads pretty quickly through to the rest of Latin America.
Finally, something we can agree on. But why?
In the first part of the 19th century, coffee growing begins to accelerate in Brazil. To grow coffee, you need to be in the tropics. The second thing, Brazil's huge, but of course you've got to keep your costs down. For most of the 19th century in Brazil, that's the labor of enslaved people.
By the mid-19th century, Brazil became the world's largest grower. In the 1900s, it was supplying 3/4 of the U.S.'s coffee imports. But beans in Colombia and Central America were also making a splash up north. Though coffee wasn't the only thing moving upward across the Americas. Throughout the 20th century, the U.S. saw immigration spike from various Latin American countries, especially Mexico and Cuba. At the same time, the Puerto Rican population in New York City skyrocketed. Gregorio Bustelo, a Spaniard who fostered a love of coffee in Cuba, followed the Puerto Rican masses to New York City. It was there he founded Café Bustelo, a bold, flavored, espresso-style coffee bean. Gregorio and his beloved Café Bustelo soon became a connector for Latinx people seeking a flavor of home in a cup and community. And like beans in Brazil, business boomed. Café Bustelo cemented itself as a staple of Latinx coffee culture throughout America. But Gregorio wasn't the only one brewing ideas. The past century has seen an exponential rise in Latinx entrepreneurs.
1 in 3 Latinos are immigrants, but 1 in 2 Latinx-owned businesses are immigrant-owned. Latinx-owned businesses are widely represented in various industries, ranging from tech to finance to what we're talking about today, coffee. In California, for example, we are seeing Latinx entrepreneurs choosing areas with high Latinx population to open specialty coffee shops and are finding a lot of success. This craving for familiarity could really be the driving force behind their success.
Today, there are over 60 million Latinx people living in the United States, with unique yet shared journeys as rich and bold as the coffee beans we love. Si bien, no hay una sola forma de ser Latinx o participar con nuestra cultura del café, Café Bustelo sigue siendo un favorito. It may even have inspired some of the entrepreneurs of today. Who's to say? All we know is the coffee bean that traveled the world is part of many Latinx stories. Whether it's simply our daily drink of choice, the foundation of our businesses, or even the subject of a 100% true, facts-only scientific internet video.